friends, welcome back to my channel. Today, I just wanted to let you guys know that we hit over 1,000 subscribers. I'm just so thankful for each and every one of you. Thank you so much for participating in the giveaway, and thank you so much for subscribing to my channel, whether you've supported me from the very beginning to just yesterday to right now to after you watch this video. Thank you so much for getting me to this milestone. It's been such a journey. The thing about making videos, you guys, is that you guys have to really love it and enjoy it. Oftentimes, people join YouTube just to make money, and it just doesn't happen like that. You have to put in some hard work, some hard effort, and some fucking really hard work and effort. It's really time consuming. You really have to be creative, and I'm all for people to start their own YouTube channels. I've put my ego aside. I'm like, anyone can start their own YouTube channel. I colored my hair, so I'm really like stoked about it. I keep touching my hair. You guys already know how that goes. I'm just so happy that we are now past 1,000 subscribers, and I just can't wait until you guys hit 1,000,000 subscribers with your girl, Beauty Queen V. I will be hosting a giveaway, and obviously there's going to be 3 winners. I've always talked about this. I've hosted a giveaway at my 100 milestone, and then I also just hosted a giveaway for my Best Damn Beauty. There was a winner for Best Damn Beauty, and she was selected, emailed. That package is all sent off, so that giveaway for the Best Damn Beauty is closed. I am starting to purchase for the giveaway, really planning for the giveaway, so just stay tuned and bear with me because I'm purchasing for 3 people, 3 makeup bags, 3 goodies, whatever I decide to do. It costs an arm and a leg. Thank you so much for getting me to over 1,000 subscribers. You guys are my ride or die. I will be continuing to do YouTube videos for as long as I would like. So for today's video, I did use all Anastasia Beverly Hills, I was gonna say ingredients. I did use all of Anastasia Beverly Hills' products pretty much for the most part. I did use her stick foundation, and I did use the stick foundation along with Nicole Guerrero's Best Damn Beauty Oil because I feel that's the only way that this little stick works, because it just causes it so much easier to like blend out and all that jazz. I loved it. I just love the complexion. We did use the Modern Renaissance palette. Everyone and their mom has one. It's amazing. You guys deserve to have it. Oh my god, I just caused a little divot in there. But anyways, I absolutely love this look. I had so much fun creating it, and honestly, it was really, really fast. The contour, blush, and highlight have been like my go-tos, and then this lip color is amazing. It's the Revlon Ultra HD Matte Lip Color, and I just love it. It's matte, but just has a velvety feel to it, and it's just super, super awesome. So again, if you are interested in the Best Damn Beauty products, don't forget to be using my discount code BeautyQueenV to save yourself 20% at checkout. Per usual, all of the products will be listed down below in the description box. Don't forget to like this video for your baby girl. Comment. I love to interact with you guys. Really hope that you guys like whoa, getting too excited over here. If you are interested into seeing how I get this look right here, then please just keep watching. I love leaving my hair down while doing my makeup. I don't know why. It just makes me feel pretty. I already did my brows, and I did use the Anastasia Brow Wiz. I do use kind of like a lighter pencil, and I don't necessarily think that your brows need to match your hair in order for it to look nice or whatever. So anyways, my brows are on, and I did prime my eyelids using the famous Tarte Shape Tape Concealer. This stuff is absolutely amazing. If you see any review about it, you are going to get a really good review. And if you're thinking about buying it, then you definitely should, because it is amazing. What we're going to be using today is products that I have not yet to try, and I'm so excited because it's the Anastasia foundation stick, or it's the stick foundation, excuse me. This is what the actual packaging looks like. I actually got her concealer as well. I heard that her concealer clumps or something like that. I heard that it creases. It doesn't clump, it creases. At least that's what like someone else had said. On me personally, I haven't actually tried it. So that's what we're going to be doing today. And I'm super excited. We'll be using a palette as well. The Modern Renaissance palette. And I'm super excited. So let's get started. I'm just gonna throw in some color into the crease. I'm gonna be using a Sigma tapered blending brush. This is an E40. You guys have seen me use this brush time and time again, and I will continue to be using it time and time again. This palette is absolutely beautiful. I love it so much. Really attracted to these burgundy colors. And I kind of want to throw that into my crease. Take Love Letter and Vietnam Red. Those two have been my favorite go-tos as of lately. I'm just placing this eyeshadow on the outer part of the crease. Slowly working it into the inner portion of the crease, but definitely I want the intensity to be more so on the outer part of the crease. And I really want it to be like a really blowing out effect. And so I'm going to do this side. Sometimes less is more. Granted, this may seem like it's a huge pop of color, but this is the only color that we're going to be using. Working it into the crease. This is also going to contour your eyelids, especially for me because I feel like I have really flat eyelids. And the more that you blend it into the crease, the more of an intense look. I'm going to take Golden Ochre. And I'm just going to put that on top of the Venetian Red along with the Love Letter. Just to tone it down just a little bit. I'm going to highlight my brow bone using a brush looking like this and taking, it's called Tempura. I'm going to place that on my brow bone. This is going to add some structure to your actual eyeshadow look. And it's also going to enhance your brow. Taking one of my favorite brushes, this is from The Balm, with no extra product in there, I'm just going to blend that out. We are going to move on to lashes, and I will be using Nicole Guerrero's Eyelur lashes. These are her 143s and I absolutely love them. They're her more glamorous lashes as opposed to the casually glamorous ones, but don't get it twisted. I love me the casually glamorous ones as well. The lashes are on. I love the 143s. They're super glamorous. I love to wear the lashes without any liner, and I love to wear it with just a blended out smoky eye. So I'm gonna go in with her foundation stick, and I did get the color tan. Now, what I did see someone use, which I was super excited about, because we all know that Nicole Guerrero did launch a highlighter palette launching March the 1st, I believe, with Anastasia Beverly Hills, and that is just like a dream come true. I'm so happy for her. But I do have the Nicole Guerrero Best Damn Beauty products, and if you use discount code BeautyQueenV, you can get 20% off the Best Damn Beauty products, and I think it's amazing. So on Instagram, I did see someone use the Best Damn Beauty oil along with the foundation stick. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to take the beauty oil. And I just love the little medicine dispenser that it's made of. It's so cute. We're gonna put a little bit on the actual foundation stick. Ooh, I really, really like that. Ooh, I feel like by using the beauty oil, it really helps the foundation stick to really blend out so easily. It does add some moisturization in there as well. I really like it. Let me put the cap back on because it's no bueno if you leave your caps off anything, including your eyelash adhesive. I'm gonna go in with a flat top kabuki first, just to see how it blends out. I usually use a beauty blender, but for this, I will be using a flat top kabuki. This is actually by B. Bella, and it's called a flat buffer brush. I absolutely love the way the flat buffer brush blends out the product. Especially with the Best Damn Beauty Oil. It's so seamless. It gives you such a radiant, flawless finish. This is the first time in a really long time that I have not used my beauty blender. So this is actually like a really big deal. But of course, you know me, I do grab my damp beauty blender. I just like to make sure that everything is nice and blended out. Wow. I think that if it weren't for the Best Damn Beauty oil, I don't think that the foundation stick would have blended out as well as it did. As you can see, it just blends out so beautifully. It covers up any redness of the face, any texture of the face, it smoothens it out. And we're gonna try Anastasia Beverly Hills' concealer. I'm kind of nervous about this one because I did get reviews that it creased throughout the day or like whenever you initially apply it. So I'm just going to take the actual product, take the damp beauty blender and directly apply it in there. Wow, right away, I just can feel how thick and heavy it is. So I can understand why someone would feel that this would crease on them. If you're dry, I feel like you're really going to like this product. I have dry skin, and my initial impression is that I really like it. You always want to look up when you are applying your concealer because you want to get into those fine lines that are underneath your eye. I'm going to say that I really, really enjoy this concealer. I do feel that you have to set it, but we're not going to do that just quite yet. I'm going to grab the same amount of product that I did the other side. And we're gonna do this part of the under eye. I'm really impressed by it. I really love the texture of it. I mean, but do keep in mind that I do have dry skin. My skin is really absorbing the concealer and it's working super, super nice. Enough with the concealer. We're gonna go ahead and set it. I am going to be using my Kat Von D translucent powder. This stuff is amazing. Let me tell you, it is like a cloud. It's like the texture of a cloud. It's so soft, so fluffy, so beautiful, and it's so like bouncy and pouncy, and I just love the texture. It's really, really thick. I have the Laura Mercier one, and I think it's absolutely disgusting. I hate the texture. It's so thin. I don't get the hype about it. This one is $2 more expensive, and it's so much better. If you have not yet to try it, then I highly recommend that you do. So smooth. It's like a Photoshop look, and I absolutely love that. Now we're gonna go in with the Laura Geller. This is the Baked Balance and Brighten. It's a foundation in the color medium, and I absolutely love this stuff. Oh my gosh, it leaves your skin so radiant, and I mostly just put it on my cheeks. Of course, on my forehead, just anywhere we put our foundation, including our neck. And of course, around the mouth. I'm gonna blend away the bakage that we had from Kat Von D's translucent powder. This is like the perfect time to do so. Just look at the complexion. I love it. I love it so much. We are going to take a nude pencil, and this is by Wet n Wild, and it's a coal liner, and I'm just going to apply that on my lower lash line. That right there is just going to make your eyes look bigger. It just really does give you such a delicate look to the eye, and I really like that. We're gonna take our Modern Renaissance palette yet again. I did grab a Morphe brush, and I really like the shape of it. It's perfect to apply eyeshadow on your lower lash line. So we're gonna go ahead and grab, I think I wanna do a brown color. I'm gonna grab Raw Sienna and maybe the burnt orange and apply that on my lower lash line. So taking the Voluminous Butterfly mascara, I'm just going to coat my lower lashes. I used to not apply mascara on my lower lashes. I just thought that my lashes were too short, too thin, and I just absolutely hated it until I started actually doing it. It really grew on me, and so now I just feel like it just gives it so much more intensity, and it just makes your makeup look more sultry and sexy, if you will. So let's move on to contour, blush, and highlight, and then we'll be done. I'm gonna zoom you guys out just a little bit because I really want to show you guys the actual shape of my cheeks without being so up close and personal, because I don't want to be all up in your face. With our contour, we're going to be using a fan brush. Yes, bitch, a fan brush. Using the Too Faced Sweetheart bronzer. This is the Baked Luminous Glow Bronzer in Sweet Tea. I just love the packaging. It's so cute, and it looks like it has like a little crown right here, and it's adorable. So taking my fan brush, I'm gonna dip that into there. I'm gonna identify the hollows of my cheeks, and I am going to contour with my fan brush. I saw Nikki Tutorials do this, and I was like, oh my God, that is such a brilliant idea. Like, why didn't I come up with that idea? Just to make sure that there are no particular like harsh lines, I'm gonna take a brush. Just going to pat that out. Just because I'm into blending and shit. I've really come to love a blush brush, and it's by Sonia Kashuk, and this is what it looks like, and it's so perfect for the cheek. Like, I just put it right here, and it just like, the shape of the brush, the way it's shaped, it's just like has a dome looking look to it, and I just really enjoy that because it's perfect for the cheek. And I will be using the Sweethearts. This is the Perfect Flesh Blush, and this is in the color Sparkling Bellini. It's just like a coral peach color, and I love me a peach blush. I love peach undertones, especially for the complexion of my skin. I just feel like it looks really beautiful. All you need is a little dab. Like, over the years of me doing makeup, I feel like I've applied too much blush, and I just figured out that, you know, less is more. I'm going to be using a highlighter from The Balm. This is the Mary Luminizer. I got this on Hot Look. Oh my God, on Hot Look, I got 3 palettes, the Juvia's palettes. I'm so excited. I got them for $19, and they're usually $35. So if you don't know what Hot Look is, look it up, big boy. I'm going to take another fan brush just like this. This is one of my older ones. It's kind of nasty. And we are going to highlight our cheekbones. And then I'm going to go ahead and take the extra product, run it down my nose, and then of course on the forehead, and then on the chin. I also really like to hit the Cupid's bow as well. We are going to apply some lip hydrator. Whoa, that smack was loud. Just going to tone down the highlight just a little bit. I can tend to get a little bit carried away. I forgot to contour my nose, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that right now. And I have to look like in a downward motion. And let me just contour my nose, hold on. Cause this mirror looking straight ahead works perfectly. I love to contour my nose. I used to not contour my nose for the longest time until I did. Take the Modern Renaissance palette one more time. Yes, one more time. I'm gonna take this Primavera color and then a brush like this, and I'm going to highlight my inner tear duct. I really do need to put some supercharged lip hydrator onto my lips because it is a lifesaver. Here's my empty supercharged lip hydrator, but there's enough for like 8 more uses. And I love the way it smells. Oh, by the way, Best Damn Beauty, if you use my code, you get yourself some 20% off at Beauty Queen V at checkout. We are going to be using the Revlon Ultra HD Matte Lip Color. This is just like a cream velvet lipstick. It's been my go-to. And I just can't get enough of it. And it smells really good too. Now we just have to set our face. And we are going to be using Milani's Make It Last Setting Spray. This is a Prime, Correct, and Set 16-hour wear setting spray. And I've already used so much of it. It smells so good. But anyways, that is the completed look, you guys. Thank you so much for watching. As always, I really hope that you guys learned something from this YouTube video. Hopefully some products, you know, kind of grabbed your attention just a little bit. If you end up grabbing the Anastasia Stick Foundation, let me know because I really highly recommend it, especially with some kind of beauty oil. It doesn't necessarily have to be Nicole Guerrero's beauty oil, but definitely for the stick foundation, it definitely needs an oil because it just changes the way that your makeup looks. I mean, it does give it such a radiant, dewy look to the face, and I really like that because that's man-made, and we can create that with the power of makeup. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like this video. Hopefully you guys learned something. Let me know if any of these products grabbed your attention. Don't ever let anyone dull your sparkle, and I'll be seeing you in my next video.